Yo, what's good, fam? Haven't done a vlog in a little bit, but about to be heading over to my buddy's place. He's also in the Navy, and he's gonna give you some knowledge. We're gonna have a dinner meeting, and yeah, just kind of go over business, go over the Navy for you guys, and drop some knowledge.
What up, bro?
What's up, bro? How you doing?
Introduce yourself to the fans.
My name is John Willis, aka Abstract Brother of God, or Abro for short. Yep.
Let them know, because we got a lot of Navy peeps, so they wanna know your rate and everything. What you give them a little rundown.
I'm in the Navy, been in for like 10 years. I'm a religious program specialist. So if y'all don't know, that's like a chaplain's assistant. I work with chaplains. I'm about to get out. I'll be 12 years when I get out, so I got 2 more years left. And
nice.
Going back to Japan, you know, with my wife and family.
All right.
Just whereas I hate your lower rank than me, so I'm still paying for you. But regardless, even if you...
All right, guys, we just went and got some dinner real quick, ate some good grub. Vietnamese, I believe, right?
Yeah.
Pho Cali.
Yep.
Is it pho or pho?
Pho. Pho Cali, Vietnamese place.
It was pretty good. They had vegan, so, you know, I was set. And, yeah, now he's going to drop some knowledge for you guys on RP.
So, like I said, I'm a religious program specialist in the Navy. I've been doing it for about 10 years. The RP rating, or religious program specialist, what it is you're the chaplain's assistant. It's really split into two parts. It's overall, you're an assistant for the chaplain. You manage like his program, anywhere from like stuff that's administrative, logistics stuff, like ordering supplies, setting up any programs he's going to be doing, or any type of events, anywhere from like weddings, funerals, then stuff of that nature. Pretty much you're a behind the scenes type person for the chaplain to help them be successful, even like if it's like you know, classes that they do. One of the big things that all religious program specialists have to know how to do is set up services, because they work with different type of religions, you know, different pastors or different chaplains, and anywhere from a priest to you know, a Muslim chaplain or a rabbi, and you have to know how to set up their service. Of course, they'll show you, but you have to get used to like setting it up. Really, the thing about this job, Phil, is you have to be diverse. And, you know, it's, you can have your own religion, but it's all about being more accepting to all religions, because you might have somebody come to you saying that they want to try to find a nearby Muslim prayer service, or you know, or find a, you know, nearby you know, Catholic parish. And you can't just be like, well, I'm gospel, so I don't know anything about that. Like, you have to put yourself aside and try to find the resources for them to go on and exercise their faith. So it's a really interesting job field. I enjoyed it the whole time I'm in. One of the big things, and I think I told Jonathan this before, that I enjoyed about it, I think it's probably the best job field, not just in the Navy, but in the military, because it's a hybrid. It's almost like a civilianized military person, because you do a lot of outreach stuff. If it wasn't for this job, I wouldn't be. I actually do art. I'm actually a hip hop dancer, and I do different type of concept arts. I got to travel all around the world. My wife is Japanese, and after this, I'm moving back to Japan. I've been working in Japan, me and my good friend, and we're gonna be, all of us are gonna be doing art together and stuff like that. And I feel like I wouldn't have had those opportunities, just to cut it short in that sense, if it wasn't for this job rating, because it's, you do a lot of outreach stuff. Like I was saying, you're a program manager, so you get to talk to, like, for example, your chaplain might be like, hey, I want you to do a community service project for our sailors and Marines, and I want this to be like an outreach project to the school. So I might have to call some school, wherever it's at, either in the States or if I'm overseas in the country. A lot of times they'll do like these type of things, like when we're deployed overseas. So you might be in a certain foreign country, and I might have to talk to some random principal in this country, and, you know, hopefully they speak English, and try to translate the best I can. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we do like projects at the school, anywhere from like reading or teaching the kids basic stuff, or painting their school or any type of community service type events. And it builds relations with the military, but at the same time, too, it opens you up to different things. Like, I've gained, I think, about 7 or 8 job opportunities in Japan just by my job alone doing outreach stuff like schools and universities and things of that nature, just being saying that I do hip-hop in my off time. So when I get out in 2 years, I'll move back and I'll be going to these jobs all because of my job field. So I think it's really one of the best outreach fields that, or, well, not outreach, but yeah, because it does outreach, but yeah, one of the best, like, jobs in the military you can really do, because you get off time. It's kind of like anything else, like you'll deploy and stuff like that, but it's really cool because you get to see a lot of different things and it's kind of relaxed. I mean, don't get me wrong, there is cons about it. Like, a lot of times it's just going to be you and the chaplain, and the chaplain hasn't had as much training as other counterparts you'll see in the military that have more sense with it. So it's like you'll be stuck a lot of times figuring out stuff on your own. You got to be more of an independent person, which means you got to learn how to ask for help, because you're not always going to have that person to work with you. Because in a lot of different job fields in the Navy, it's very group oriented. And if it's like, oh, you got to lift something heavy, somebody's going to say, like, oh man, let me help you. You know what I'm saying? Like, with a religious program specialist, it might just be that person. So he has to go to somebody else of a different department and say, hey, can you help me? And they're like, yeah, I'll go send some people to help you and go from there. You know what I'm saying? So you gotta be talkative. You gotta be willing to step out. So pretty much if you're an extrovert, oh, I said that wrong. Sorry. If you're an introvert, it's going to be really hard for you. But if you're an extrovert, like a person that likes getting out and being eccentric and talking to people, it'll be okay for you. But yeah, if you're an introvert, it's gonna be kind of hard.
Yeah. All right, guys. Well, there you have it. You know, do with that knowledge what you will. But definitely some major nuggets that you guys need to take into consideration and definitely implement in the future.